Hello and welcome to the channel Scene with Chips. If you've been here before, then welcome back. Thanks for coming back. If you haven't been here before, then please consider subscribing and pressing the bell button so you can be notified of videos that I'm making throughout the year. Right, today, the video I'm making today is just a comparison really between the Harley Davidson dealerships in the States compared with the Harley Davidson dealerships in Europe and the UK. When you consider the size of the dealerships in America to the size of the dealerships over in the UK and in Europe, it's really quite considerable. But also, I think what the dealerships do for their customers over in America seems to be a lot more as well. They seem to get involved in a lot of a lot more social events, barbecues, beer evenings, and such like. And as you'll see by a couple of the clips that I put on today, there's quite a lot going on. What is concerning as well is the way that Harley have spoken to their dealerships at the moment and saying that they've all got to conform to be exactly the same. So all of their shop floors have got to look identical. Everything's got to be in the same place. I believe in the UK there's 5 dealerships that have shut down already, 2 that I know of, which is Jersey Harley Davidson and Bridgewater Harley Davidson. I believe they're closing down as of the 31st of December, but from what I can gather there's another 3 Wars in London have shut one of their stores, I believe, so I don't know who the other 2 are, but it seems as though we're going to be struggling to have dealerships over here in the UK. The dealerships that I actually visited when I was over in America in this last trip was, I went to Palm Beach Harley Davidson, I went to Alligator Alley Harley Davidson in Fort Lauderdale, I went to Space Coast Harley Davidson, which is up near Cape Canaveral, hence the reason Space Coast, and also down to Miami, to Peterson's Harley Davidson. They had 2, both North Miami and South Miami, 2 Harley Davidson dealerships that were absolutely fantastic. I think I met the manager there who runs both of them, and he had them set out really well. So what I'm gonna do is just show you a brief video of each of these Harley Davidson dealerships. This is Palm Beach Harley Davidson, quite a large dealership, sitting in the tips of Florida on the way to Florida Keys. They say there's a shortage of bikes, but there doesn't seem to be a shortage of bikes here. Maybe it's a shortage of new bikes that we've got, but there's certainly a lot of bikes for sale in this particular dealership. It's another sunny day in Florida, and we've come to yet another Harley Davidson dealership. This is Alligator Alley Harley Davidson, and they seem to have a lot of motorbikes again. This shortage of bikes that they talk about, I don't know where it is. Maybe it's just Europe and the UK, but this is another massive dealership. They really are enormous, these places. Thank you.
This is Space Coast Harley Davidson, not far from the Cape Canaveral Space Center, hence the reason why it's called Space Coast Harley Davidson. But again, loads and loads of bikes in here. Not a lot in the accessory side, unless they're running short on stock at the moment and waiting to restock with all the new 120th anniversary gear. But certainly another big Harley Davidson.
So you can see by the short videos there, the immense size of these dealerships in the US makes the European and UK ones look a little bit like a corner shop. But I suppose they've got the footfall and the space to have the size of dealerships there are. But the only thing that concerns me is that this that I was talking about before with all the dealerships having to conform and look the same, does that not sort of make you feel as though, well, if you're a Harley rider, you tend to go to a different dealership to visit it, have a coffee, meet up with other people, and you're looking for it being a bit different. But if it's all looking the same, then what's the point in going to a different dealership? I don't know what you think, but anyway, leave a comment, let me know what you think, okay? And hopefully I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.